Hello, I'm Richard Campbell and I'm the Technical Director for Hydrosense, and I'll be showing you how to use the Swab Test Kit. The Swab Test Kit comes in two different pack sizes. We have a single test kit and we also have a 5 test kit format. I'll be demonstrating just on a single test kit. The test has a LOD of 200 CFU per swabbed area, and the test is used for swabbing a range of different surfaces, including stainless steel and plastic that I have here today. The sample size and the swabbing area should be 10 centimeters squared. I've marked out a rectangle here, which is 5 by 2, which is 10 centimeters squared. That's approximately the same size as the label that's on the front of the foil. Now, you can sample larger areas, but the minimum size of 10 centimeters squared must be sampled. If your surface is dry, in the case of these ones here, then you should pre-moisten the swab. So to do that, remove the swab from its packaging, open the vial containing the buffer, dip the swab in, remove the excess liquid, and then swab your area. As you're swabbing, if you turn the swab so that all surfaces of the swab are covered, that will help maximize the recovery of any bacteria. So once we've swabbed the area, we can then transfer the swab to the vial. And on the swab handle, there's a red mark. And at that point, we can snap off the handle, and that allows us to replace the lid on the vial. We then shake the vial for at least 20 seconds to remove the bacteria and the biofilm from the swab into the buffer. And once we've done that for 20 seconds, we're then ready to run the test. So we can remove the test from its packaging just prior to running the test and place the test on a flat surface. Also in the foil, you'll find an exact volume pipette. It's important to use this pipette correctly. When we are using it, we only ever press the top bulb and not this bottom bulb here. So in order to take our sample from the vial and get it into the pipette, what we do is remove the lid, press the top bulb in, and then place the tip of the pipette into the solution, and then release the bulb, drawing up the liquid into the pipette. This volume here in the tube is exactly 100 microliters, and we can see here there's excess liquid has been deposited into the bottom bulb. So to transfer the liquid from the tube into the cassette, we press the top bulb again by holding the pipette over the test. Make sure that all the liquid is dispensed, and then we will start a timer for 25 minutes. The test should be read between 25 and 30 minutes, and it should not be read before 25 minutes or after 30 minutes. The test is composed of two lines, a test line and a control line. If both lines are present, then Legionella pneumophila serogroup 1 has been detected above the cutoff of the test kit. The positive signal at the test line may well be weak, but any line at this position indicates a positive. If no test line is present at the test line position, but there is a control line, then the test is negative and Legionella pneumophila serogroup 1 has not been detected. If no control line is present, then the test is invalid and it should be repeated. To use the app, launch the app, select a pre-programmed location, and click Read Test. Scan the barcode, and then read the test by matching up the image on the screen with the cassette. The positive result indicates that Legionella pneumophila serogroup 1 has been detected in the sample. Results can be shared via email or SMS. Our results are also automatically uploaded to the Hydrosense Pro portal at hydrosensepro.com.